everybody, and welcome to another NetHunt CRM tutorial. Today, we're going to learn how to import your data into NetHunt. You might be using another software or keeping your data in spreadsheets at the moment. No worries, you can migrate all the data into NetHunt CRM in a few clicks. First of all, you need to prepare for import. You need to collect all the data you have in a file and clean it up. I would recommend doing it in a spreadsheet. Check out my webinar on how to make it happen. I left the link in the description. So, let's say you have two files to import: your company's data and the deals you already have with them. Those are two different files. The company's file have the information about the accounts. The deals file has the info about them, and also super important, there is a field with the company name they belong to. Remember, the company name in the deals file and the company name in the company's file must be the same. This will allow NetHunt to link your deals to their companies. So, I have my spreadsheet with companies all clean and ready to be migrated into NetHunt. I click on the file option and download it as a CSV. Now, I go to NetHunt and choose the import feature. I choose to import from CSV, but in case you move from another CRM, you can do it directly with no files involved. So I drag and drop my CSV file to upload and choose the company's folder to import to. You can also select a new one to be created on the go. It is not necessarily to import into the existing folder if it is a completely new data not relevant to the existing folders. But I will be importing my companies into the existing folder in this video. The further stage is to map the fields. The CSV column name shows the names of the rows from your file. The CSV data example gives you an overview of one company, and the fields in NetHunt CRM column shows where you need to map the fields correctly from the file you are importing, well, in our case it is a spreadsheet, to the folder fields. The system will catch the field names and formats automatically if there is a possible correlation. But you do need to check them all. What we see here: the system mapped some fields correctly, like name went to name, website to website. Here, there is a new field, meaning that there was no such existing field like stage in the folder. But if you click here, you will see that there is a similar field with the name status. You can choose this one to import your company stages from a spreadsheet to the existing status field. Scrolling down, everything looks well. Now, the time since field update cannot be mapped. Why? Imagine you initially exported your data from another system into a spreadsheet. Now you are importing it into NetHunt. The system field like this might not be found in NetHunt CRM. Therefore, we cannot find a format to map it to. If you need to keep this data in NetHunt, click here and create a new field. There is a field suggestion, but I'd rather select a text format. The quote stage is the new field created in a text format. But since these are the stages, I can choose it to be of a drop-down nature. So you will have a menu of quote stages. Same with the last email sent. It is a system field and I can choose it to be migrated as a date. There is also a description field I had in my spreadsheet. I can save it as a comment, not a field, and when I open the company record, I will see it on the timeline. Okay, great. Now we go to the final step. We need to check for the duplicates. If in the future you import the second batch of companies, the data you are importing might be already available in NetHunt. You can check for duplicates and handle matches. Scan the duplicates by field you need. In the company's folder, it can be a name. If you are importing contacts, for example, I would recommend mapping by the email as it will be the unique field. And then choose what to do with those duplicates. Merge the duplicates and update them with the new data or skip them. Okay, awesome. Now, import the data and go to the company's folder. As you see, all the new companies are safe and sound in the NetHunt folder. So what's next? Now we will import the deals. I download them as a CSV file and import them into the deals folder. Here, we have an important field, which is company. It will be the link between the folder deals and the companies they belong to. In my spreadsheet, I have the company names over here that must be the same as the record names of the companies I imported into the companies folder. Here we can see the same statistic fields that we learned about previously, and they are recommended to be imported as a date in the last email sent and as a text entry or a number in the statistics field. Formula field is not mapped, as the formula in your origin file can differ from the one that we set up in NetHunt. So, you can either import it or skip. Later on, you can add a new formula field in the deals folder and set it up. The numbers will be automatically calculated. Okay, great. Going on to check the duplicates and importing the deals. Now I go to the imported deal and see the perfectly migrated data. And look, the deal is linked to a company. You can click on it and see the company's profile and the related deal down below. So, having imported files, you can also go to the folder settings and adjust some of them, like adding the formula field was skipped, or remove some others. More info on the customization in NetHunt you can check out in our video tutorial that I also left in the description down below. If you found this video useful, hit those like and subscribe buttons. We post informational videos every week, so let us know what you want to hear about next week in the comments below. If you still haven't tried NetHunt, sign up today for free. The link is in the description. Bye for now.